the name of Allah, our Creator, the Creator of the universe and of everything that's in it, I greet you all, dear viewers, in our Islamic way. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, blessings, and mercy be with you all. We are still continuing with our discussion about Islam and science, and this episode is particularly discussing the problem of the current pollution of our environment and the recent climatic changes that are threatening the future of humanity at large. Over-industrialization has done a great harm to humanity because Allah has created everything in that universe with a very critical balance. To tilt that balance, you are bound to destroy the harmony of the environment you are living in. Recently, man has been burning over 10 billion barrels of oil annually. Man has been burning over 8 billion tons of coal annually. Man has been burning several trillions of cubic feet of natural and unnatural gases annually. And man thinks that the product of this burning will be released to outer space and will not harm the environment on our planet. Sadly enough, scientists have come to realize that the net result of burning fossil fuel leads to very many heavy gases like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur oxides, nitrogen oxides. Many oxides are produced as a result of burning fossil fuel. And these gases that are produced are heavy gases. And that's how they cannot escape to outer space. They remain in the atmospheric zone surrounding the Earth. With these gases remaining in the lower atmosphere, can lead to the formation of what we call acid rain. And acid rain is very destructive to living tissues in plants, animals, and humans, can be very destructive to building materials such as wood or iron or cement or rock material. It can be very, very destructive to life in general. Let alone, it's a great danger to living beings when inhaled carbon dioxide or carbon monoxide or sulfur oxides. All these are poisonous gases that can destroy living tissues and can create many ailments and many diseases to human beings, to animals, and to plants. Not only this, but excessive industrialization has produced many cars, many trains, many aeroplanes, many ships that traverse the seas and oceans, and through the burning of fuel in these means of transportation, we also get not only the poisonous gases that result from burning of these fuels, but also we get the breaking down of the tar material that we use for pavement, for paving roads. We can get many of the reducing gases that can reach the ozone layer. And the ozone layer is a layer at an elevation of about 25 to 30 kilometers above ground surface. And this layer, the Creator has produced to protect life on the surface of that planet from ultraviolet radiations that are coming with the sun rays. And if these radiations were allowed to penetrate the ozone layer, which is being currently destroyed through over-industrialization, through overproduction of reducing gases, such as the chlorofluorocarbon gases, which are used in refrigerators, in air conditioning equipments, which are used also in spraying material. If you break this ozone layer and make an ozone hole, ultraviolet radiation can penetrate easily to the surface of the ground and can harm humans, animals, plants, can create fireworks in woody regions, can be absolutely harmful to the eyesight of man and animals. So man is destroying his environment by his own hands. And sadly enough, the greed for money, the greed for wealth, the greed for power has made man of our time completely blind of the dangers he is imposing by his own hands on his own environment. Nowadays we have polluted soil, we have polluted water masses, we have polluted gaseous atmosphere. So every environment around us has been highly polluted by the madness of our industrialization. The current material civilization is mainly aiming at mass production, at any scale. Produce as much as you can, and sell as much as you can, and buy as much as you can, regardless of any harms this process can create to the environment. And this again stems from the fact that people do not believe in the afterlife, do not believe in the fact that they will be held responsible on the day of judgment for every action they have taken, for every word they have uttered, for every penny they earned and spent. People have completely ignored the life to come and have completely ignored their responsibility in front of their Creator. And that's why we need Islam. We need to teach people Islam. We need to teach people their exact role on the surface of that planet. We have to teach people that men and women, the children of Adam and Eve, are vicegerents on the surface of that planet, entrusted with it for a very short span of time, the lifetime of every one of us. And we are here to worship our Creator in the way He has prescribed for us, and to play our role as good vicegerents on Earth, preserving the environment as much as we can, and saving the humanity around us and the creation around us from any harm our hands can produce. The sense of responsibility is the only cure to the greed of the people of our time, the greed of the civilization we are living in. The materialistic attitude which has governed man in our time. So really we have to make people aware of the great danger they are imposing on their planet, on their environment, on their fellow men and women. And we have to make them aware of the responsibility of this malbehavior in this world and in the world to come. Of course, there are many alternatives to solve many of these problems. But before I talk about the solutions, I have to say that these gases that are steadily accumulating in the lower atmosphere can create what we call thermal occlusion. Thermal occlusion means a steady increase in the temperature of the lower atmosphere. And this steady increase comes from the fact that the Earth is heated during the day by sunshine. Most of that energy is absorbed by the rocks of the Earth. Once the sun sets, these rocks irradiate the energy they have stored during the daytime. Clouds can reflect some of this irradiated energy back to us to warm our environment during the nighttime, but a certain percentage escapes to the outer atmosphere. If I form a greenhouse effect by the heavy gases of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur oxides, nitrogen oxides, I make a blanket, a greenhouse effect around the Earth. The excessive amount of heat that Allah has planned that it should leave the Earth every night will be occluded, will be imprisoned. And this can lead to the gradual increase in the temperature of the lower atmosphere night after night. That's what's known currently as thermal occlusion. This thermal occlusion has got a great danger because it threatens life immensely. First of all, it can cause the great quantities of ice stored at the two poles of the Earth and at the peaks of mountains to melt. And if this ice was to melt, it can raise the water level in seas and oceans to a level that can drown all oceanic islands, all deltas in the world, all coastal plains, all the depressed areas. And this is the most heavily inhabited environments on the surface of our planet. If you drown these, man will not find enough space to live on, enough land to cultivate, enough food to eat, and actually you can destroy our planet immensely. Not only this, but the thermal occlusion can completely change the direction of wind on the surface of our planet. And disturbing the plan of the movement of the winds, which Allah has designed for our planet, can cause immense droughts in areas that used to have a great quantity of rain, and can cause really monsoon rains, and can create flooding rains in areas that never had that before. We will have a short break and we'll come back to you within a few seconds. Welcome back, dear viewers. Before this short break, we were talking about the sad consequences of the pollution of our environments. And we said that thermal occlusion, which is created by the greenhouse effect of the many gases, many heavy gases that are produced as a result of burning fossil fuel, coal, oil, and gas, the result is a blanket of these heavy gases that can envelop the earth completely and cause what we call thermal occlusion. Thermal occlusion, first of all, it's highly poisonous to life. Secondly, it can cause the melting of the great thicknesses of ice on the two poles of the earth and at the peaks of mountains. This melting can cause the rising up of the water level in seas and oceans, can create the complete drowning of all oceanic islands, such as the Hawaiian islands, the Japanese islands, the Philippine islands, the Indonesian islands. Many of these islands would be completely drowned. It can cause the flooding, complete flooding of all deltaic areas, all coastal plains, all low-lying areas on the surface of our planet. These are the actual fields that can produce food for most people of the world. And if you destroy all deltas and all coastal plains and all oceanic islands, man will not find enough food to eat. He will not find enough land to live on. Because of this, they say that thermal occlusion is a great danger. It can really cause many diseases and many sicknesses to plants, animals, and humans. It can disturb the wind plan which Allah has designed for our own planet. And this disturbance can create drought in areas which used to have enough rain to live on, can create hurricanes and cyclones in areas that never had that before, and both events can be seriously destructive to life on the surface of our planet. So really, man is destroying himself by his own hands. Man is madly creating problems for life on the surface of that planet. The greed of the material civilization we are living in, the mad, massive production of unneeded material is actually creating lots of problems for the future human beings on the surface of that planet. Here the question would rise, are there any alternatives? Yes, there is. For example, instead of burning oil and coal and natural gas in that massive quantity, we can use solar energy, we can use wind energy, we can use water energy, we can use geothermal energy. Actually, on land, we can get a gradual increment of temperature about 1 degree every 30 meters or around 30 meters. But in areas of thinning of the crust, or areas where there is intensive volcanic activity and igneous intrusions, this gradual increase of 1 degree every 30 meters can be multiplied several times. And this heat can be used for distilling seawater into fresh water, generating electricity by the superheated steam coming out from these wells and using that fresh water for spreading life. So we have very many alternatives to burning oil and gas, burning coal and other raw material of these fossil fuels. And these can be used actually as basic chemical components that can be utilized more rationally and more intellectually rather than burning them. So the alternatives are there, but people are crazy running after money without thinking about the great damage they are causing for their own selves, their own descendants, and for the future humanity on the surface of that planet. So the ozone layer, also we can find alternatives for the chlorofluorocarbon gases, which are currently used in refrigerators and air conditioning equipments, many spray bottles. We can use liquid nitrogen. And actually, it has been recommended in many of the international conferences on the environment, has been recommended to use these alternatives and to minimize the use of chlorofluorocarbon gases within a certain limit to a limited quantity. Yet, big industrial countries refuse to sign on any of the recommendations of these conferences, mainly headed by the United States of America and the other big industrial countries. So we have to change completely the culture of the time. People who are running after material gains only, regardless of the great harm they are causing to humanity, have to realize that life is not eternity, that they will die one day. They will be resurrected after death. They will be judged in front of their creator. They have to answer for every action they have taken on the surface of that planet. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is quoted to have said, the 2 feet of a human being will not be released on the day of judgment until he or she has answered for 4 basic questions. An umrihi fima afnah, his age, how did he spend? Wa an shababihi fima ablah, his youthfulness, how did he use or misuse? Wa an malihi min ayna iktasabahu wa fima anfaqa, his wealth, how did he earn and spend? Wa an ilmihi fima afada bih, and about his knowledge, how did he benefit humanity or harm humanity with? We have very many radioactive installations on the surface of the globe. These installations, whether they are producing electricity or they are being used in medication or used in many other equipments, these radioactive material are a great danger to life. And we can produce electricity without the need to go back to radioactive material. Not only the danger of leakage, as the leakage that happened with Chernobyl a few years ago, or with the Three Miles Island in the United States, or in Scotland in Britain a few years ago, and the undeclared leakages, which nobody heard anything about it. The great danger is that where can you bury the product of the depleted radioactive material? They are trying nowadays to put it in lead cases and bury it at the bottoms of seas and oceans, or bury it in the third world countries. And this burial can never be eternal. The weathering processes, the activity of the earth, the oceanic currents, all these factors can easily, volcanicity, volcanic eruption, faulting of the earth, all this can reach the storage of the depleted radioactive material. And if it is spread in the oceanic waters or on land, it can be absolutely devastating to humanity and to life at large. The 2 small bombs that were thrown on Hiroshima and Nagasaki in 1945, their effects are still felt up till now. The water, the soil, the air in these 2 cities are still polluted up until with radioactive material up until this time. And up until our time, babies are born with lots of defects. Milk comes out from the animals that are milked, polluted with radioactive material, water in rivers, in wells, in the seas are highly radioactive. The vegetation contains some radioactive material. So one has to be absolutely careful about what he is doing during his lifetime or her lifetime on the surface of that planet. We are actually destroying our environment, destroying our planet unduly, and causing harm to ourselves and to our fellow men unduly and unnecessarily. And we will be held responsible definitely for that. Because of this, I dare say that over-specialization and over-industrialization and massive production of unneeded material has led to the pollution of the atmosphere, of the soil, of the seas and oceans, the hydrosphere, have polluted everything in our own lives, and will never do good to any of the existing individuals on the surface of that planet. And the process is being aggravated year after year. And unless wise men can put a big full stop to this crazy struggle to massive mass production, this crazy struggle to mass production and mass selling and mass buying, regardless of the great dangers this is creating, only Allah knows what the future of humanity on the surface of that planet will be. So we have, again, to educate people along our Islamic lines that life is very short. Man is very responsible about that short span of time Allah has given him or her. We will be held responsible for our actions and deeds on the surface of that planet. Every pollutant we can produce will be held responsible about it. So we have to be very, very careful not to harm ourselves, not to harm our descendants, not to harm our neighbors. We have to be absolutely sensitive to any bad action that is taken by us. Otherwise, we will be questioned about that on the Day of Judgment. So life is seriously endangered by the industrial civilization we are living in. Life is seriously endangered by the material civilization we are living in. And it's a high time for Muslims to go around and teach people Islam in a nice, kind, gentle, tender way, and warn people against excessive production, excessive industrialization, excessive mass production, because this is doing a great harm to our environment. And I'll stop here, hoping that the message is clear, wishing you the best, and thanking you for your patience. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, blessings, and mercy be with you all.